Welcome back to Astro Pill. Are you ready to take a look?
Da 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 da!
Yeah.
Hell yeah! Look
party.
At him. He's beautiful.
Add lights and stuff. Okay.
Cool. Yeah, welcome back, guest expedition for Attack Down on Isil is Berkeley.
It's me.
But yeah, we just wanted to show off from the last episode. We said we promised we'd show you the Keating outfit, so there it is. Weird, muscular chess horse guy.
Showing it all. Right?
Yeah, it's real good. Also, did you eat already? Oh, you didn't eat already. Sorry.
I have not eaten.
Okay.
I'm going to make some
food. If you notice, we switched screens. So you'll be staring at Berkeley's nice character for this round. Ooh, you're getting fancy.
Oh, yeah.
Customize your menu. I just go to the chef's platter where they just pick a bunch of stuff for you. It's usually pretty good.
Let's make some food.
Yay! Look at how cute it is! We get this, like, tough, manly, awesome pirate cat. When you talk to him, his voice clip is like, he's like,
like, that's a lot of food.
Oh, that's so cute!
Wow. Oh, hell yeah!
I'm gonna eat all of this before we go.
Dude, is your guild card still
the same? It's still there.
Wait. Okay, wait. This is really important. We have to show you. Hold on. Let me see if my guild card. I forget what I set it to. Hold on. This is really important. You'll see. Okay, wait. How do you change the thingy again? How do you
like change the pose or change
the Oh, here we go. Hold on. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and show off your guild card for them while I'm doing this. Is it still the same?
Take a look. Yeah.
Wait, no, it was the other one. Hold on. This is really important. BRB. So something we found out is that you can kind of zoom in and out of so a guild card is basically your profile. You can send it to people. You can change the pose, all kinds of things, backgrounds, and I think it's new to in this game where you can zoom in and out. So of course you can zoom in very inappropriate locations. If you want a guy's crotch, have him sit down, zoom in on the crotch.
For me
though, if you check out my card, check it out, guys. Hell yeah. Hi guys, it's me.
Nice close up. Ooh. 107 matches played with the Switch app.
Oh hell yeah. Yeah, I have not used a single other one.
Nice.
A single time. Wow, I didn't even know you could see all these stats. Anyways, just wanted to show that off real quick. Not even that important, but is whatever. Okay.
What are my stats? Okay. Yeah,
that's Berkeley's guild card. That's zooming up their cat.
Blade.
Looking real good.
I played a couple rounds with some of the other weapons.
Yeah, you did. You told me that. You tried out some other weapons.
Mm-hmm.
You can clearly see what our preferences are. If you don't know what the different weapons are, that's okay. Know that the best weapon is Switch Axe. That's all you have to know.
Wait, don't you mean Charge Blade?
excuse you.
I think you spelled that wrong.
I'm going to punch you in the face with my Switch Axe.
Ouch.
The other thing is the loading time is a bit long, but it's not like super bad. It's not like ridiculous or anything, but I can do a lot on this loading screen. I can draw a whole dog.
Yeah.
Whole block of cheese. Anyways, Eater of Elders was the name of this quest. Holy crap, dude. How come it warps us like ahead of the box? You ran away from it, by the way. You didn't grab stuff
from
the box.
Yeah. No box for me.
All right, bye. You going down?
Going it solo.
Excuse me, solo as in you going to leave me out?
Like,
okay,
you know,
I can leave if you don't even want me here.
Going with my cat.
That's
my
fine. Now I'll see you later. You can handle it yourself. I'll come in eventually.
Okay.
Oh yeah, we didn't even say we're fighting the Nergigante in this one. It's kind of what'd you call it? The flagship monster of this series.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So each monster usually has this big important. They're usually new ones, right?
Yeah. Well, what was the last games? Was it
Gormagala?
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like the Rathalos was definitely the big little monster on one of them.
Yeah, pretty sure.
Lagiacris, I think, was for Tri. I think the Lagiacris was on the cover of Tri, but I can't quite remember. Anyways, so the Nergigante that we're about to fight is the cover monster, the big important monster of this game. He became infamous during the beta of Monster Hunter World. You could fight, what was it, four different monsters in the beta?
Yeah.
What were they? There was the basic one, the Jagras. It's kind of your starting monster.
There was the Anjanath, like a T-Rex looking
thing. Yeah, big old T-Rex guy that breathes fire. What else was there? There was one more in-between guy. Who was it?
Was it, like, the Gyarados, maybe?
Was it the Gyarados? I don't remember fighting, like, a water dude in the beta.
I know we fought all of them, but I can't remember what the other one was.
Wait, shoot, yeah, I can't remember. Mm-hmm. Baroth, right? It was the Baroth.
Okay,
and then the last one was the Nergigante. And the point is that he became infamous because he has this kind of two-hit kill? Mm-hmm. Would you just... Two-hit combo, instant kill kind of thing, where, like, he'll do this thing to, like, knock you to the ground, and it's really hard to get up. Not the invincibility frame. I don't know how to describe it, but, like, it takes you a super long time to get up, is what I'm saying.
Yeah,
so in the span of time where you're trying to get up, he's up in the air. Oh, God, like this. Wait, I'm gonna die. Oh, crap. Ooh. That was close.
Good thing you're pretty tough now.
Yeah. He has this move where, like, once all his spikes turn black, he'll jump up in the air and fly the heck down and, like, slide across the screen, killing everything in his path. And usually everybody died. So you get three chances before you fail the quest. So he would normally take out a lot of people during that span of time, and we just kept failing the quest over and over.
Yep.
And they give you kind of a default set of armor and stuff to choose from. So you can't really, like, customize or, like, bring extra items and craft extra items. You know, you didn't have the luxury of doing all that. So you just have this basic set of stuff, and you just had to work with it and fight this friggin' Nergigante. So we've since made mincemeat of him. He ain't too tough. He still kills me sometimes, but...
He's decently tough.
Yeah, he's not as tough as before. So it's good. We've improved. Oh god, I'm on his face! He threw me off, but it's okay. It's okay. Oh god, he's a big old spiky boy. Ah! He whipped me with his tail! Ow! Save me!
Oh no.
Did I just do the SOS flare?
Did you?
No, I didn't. Do you want me to do the SOS flare?
We could.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna make this room open to random strangers. So if they are looking for responding to SOS flares and they're looking for the Nergigante, they will find our room and come the heck on in. We'll lose our cats though, but that's okay.
Oof. Unfortunate, but are two people worth two cats? We shall see.
Someone came in already, that was fast. Guess people really need the Nergigante. Ow! It's okay, my cat can't heal me anymore. All he can do is steal stuff. I'm gonna have him steal something before the guy comes in. Go!
Steal something.
Am I stunned? You called, Meowster? I sure did. Go steal something. Oh! And Superman dive! I'm alive.
Yeah,
we're fine.
Alive.
That was the big old move. I don't know if you caught it all on camera, did you?
I caught it on camera.
Hell yeah, you see my sick tricks all on camera.
Oops, I started pulling these spines.
Huh?
I started investigating
Oh, yeah, yeah. So we mentioned in the previous episode that you can, like, look for tracks of the monster in order just to just track it and get more info on it and stuff. And as you level up the info, you'll find out more stuff about it. Like, it'll tell you when it's dying. What else does it tell you? It tells you a whole bunch of stuff.
I guess if it's eating or if it's... going somewhere.
Yeah, it just tells you more information about the monster the more you look at it. Oh, third guy is officially in the quest. We'll see him show up as soon as he comes on over here.
Eventually.
Yeah, but I don't remember what the hell I was talking about. Tracks. Sometimes tracks, you can pick it up real easily. You'll just, like, sniff it. You'll just smell it and pick it up real quick. But other ones, you'll sit down and, like, take some... What? The quest has reached max capacity.
Oh, so I guess the other two people are coming in?
There was a second person? I only saw Naiden.
Oh, okay. I saw someone else.
Okay.
Forgot their
name. I guess they're just still loading in.
Yeah, it does take a while, these loading times.
Oh, there they are. Donuts 45. Hello, 45. Welcome. Welcome, Donuts. Welcome to our humble channel, you guys.
Welcome to the channel.
Oh, God. I totally lost track of what I was saying. I don't know. Tracks. Oh, some of them take a long time, and you just gotta bend down and take a super long time to investigate. It just takes some real Blue's Clues business. So, anyways, that was it. That was all I was trying to say over the span of, like, a really long time. Oh, God! Oh,
ooh,
save
ouch.
Me!
Here, let me find that
powder. No.
Oh, here it is.
Yeah!
Yeah, you made it. You survived.
Oh, thanks for the heal, dude. He's coming after me. I can't, like, finish healing. Help.
I'll help you finish healing.
Oh my god. Oh my freaking god, dude. Neither of us have mounted him yet, right?
Well, I mounted it, but he knocked me off.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Does that make him non-mountable for a while?
Does
that same mechanic still apply?
Yeah. So we'd have to, like, jump on him a couple more times.
Oh, no! Oh!
Oh, you...
I dodged it by recoil of my explosion.
Nice.
Hey, where are those two slackers? Haven't seen them this entire time. Mm-hmm.
They're taking their time.
Taking their sweet time coming on over here. We need some freaking help. You know, by you coming in, that makes the monster have more health, right? Get your butt over here and contribute. Ooh. Girl? Mm-hmm. I'm on the tail. Oh no, it warded me off. Oh, he's here. So in this game, it automatically makes like a ping if you arrive close to the monster and make first contact. It was really confusing to me because it didn't. Oh, girl! It didn't do that before. Before you would only. I'm dead! I'm gonna heal you. I got you.
Thanks for the heal.
The prop. I probably need one too. I'm just gonna heal again real quick. Okay. Before, it would only ping if you chose to. So in this game, it just automatically does it if you make contact with the monster. So it's just a bit confusing. But it makes it nice to know when people have arrived, I guess. These slackers finally getting on over here.
Finally here.
Oh god. Dang it. I tried to... Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. I think that was you that made him flinch just now. You saved me. Had he gone through with his attack, I would have been Nergigante soup. Is that what it's called? No. The soup would be made of me, so I'd be hunter soup. I did it all wrong.
Mm-hmm.
This guy's horns? Too big. Very don't like big them. Horns. Unnecessarily big. Chop them off. Don't like them. Too huge. Oh god. What are the other two? So one's a greatsword and one's a switch axe, yes?
That's right.
Or is it. Yeah,
switch axe.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Huh! I was trying to leap off the spike. Mm. Oh, his wings are pretty. The tinges at the end of it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like the purple.
And purple and orange, purple, yeah, it's tinges. Pretty. Mm. Oh, y'all got swiped!
Alright, here's round two.
Oh, you're on, congrats. Here, let me make a smiley face. Oh yeah, we can communicate with everybody, but I'm really bad at it because there's a whole bunch of menus you gotta go through. There you go. Good work.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
Here, I can jump around. I can jump on his head. And start
stabbing him. Yeah, check out them moves.
Yeah.
The only thing is, though, if you play with strangers, they don't often like to talk back to you, which makes me really sad. Yeah, that's about all I wanted to say on that front. I don't like playing with other people for some reason. I just kind of prefer it being me and Berkeley and our cats. I don't know. I think the biggest thing is that... I don't really want to join a room because then we can just kind of go at our own pace and do whatever we want and don't have to kind of feel pressured.
Like just to do what everyone else wants to do?
Right? Yeah. But no, I think they created this new lobby system to eliminate that. So they'll have as many people in as possible. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So not each room isn't limited to just like one quest being demanded and you just never get your quest done. You remember that in the past?
Yeah.
You had to keep waiting in line for your quest to be done? Yeah. So this new system, oopsie, I agree. I agree with myself.
Oh, yes.
This new system makes it so that you can all kind of freely do what you want and have a bunch of different choices, which is nice. But I don't know. I just like a little privacy, little taking our time. You know? If we had more friends that were playing Monster Hunter World on PS4, maybe we would consider joining a more public room with more people.
Yeah.
But nobody's playing it that we
know.
We're
looking at you, Doughy. Looking at you, Paper.
Looking at you, Tom. All y'all.
Looking at you, Brian? Is that his name?
Yes, Brian is indeed.
Yeah, Brian.
Name. Oh no! Superman dive! I lived.
I forgot if he had like a handle name.
No, he doesn't have an alias. You and Doughy, you guys funny. Y'all not used to it. That's because you're not on the show as often, but it's just really funny. You're like, names. Oh no, he's doing it twice? Are you kidding me?
Wow.
Oh, well, it seems like everybody's fine.
Cool.
Hey, everybody's like an expert dodger now. If this were the beta, everybody'd be dead at this point.
Yeah, we'd have four people dead.
Four dead bodies.
And a quest over.
Yeah.
Like a little tired.
Hey, do you see me? Did you catch me hanging on his tail? I was real cool. Did you catch that? Did you catch me on camera, Mom? Did you see me?
We got it.
Oh god, where's he going? Hey, I thought he was running away, not trying to kill us again.
I shot him with some crystal.
Oh, dude, nice. Oh, I got some dragon pods. I'll go ahead and throw those at him.
Yeah.
Take that 7 damage. Take that 5 damage. Yeah, you know, take that. Woohoo! Yeah! Oh no, he's coming after me. He doesn't like that. Oh no.
Oh no.
Hehe. Slinging little things is fun. Are you dying? Holy crap! I got you! Run away, run away! You're not stunned, are you?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Good thing my shield is pretty tough.
Oh hey, our room friends are Japanese. They'll automatically say a phrase. Wow! Yay! Wow. I wanna say good work. Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Good work.
Yeah.
Yay! Yeah, our Japanese friends are very quiet. Please speak to us.
Cool.
Hey, stop spamming them.
Yeah, usually it goes back to its nest to sleep, but I guess we disrupted it from doing that.
Oh, okay. Yeah, everyone's real good. That went really smoothly. Nobody died?
Mm-hmm.
I was close to dying. You were like, you miraculously survived. You should have died there. You hit me.
Did I hit you?
You did. Wait.
I'm just carving.
Wait. Oh, JK.
Donuts 45.
No, it's this Daidon guy.
Oh, okay.
I thought he was you for some reason. He's trying to launch me. I'll launch him! I'll launch you! Ah, he launched me! Quick, launch him! Whoa! I just did something really cool! Ooh. I did my charge midair.
Oh, huh.
How did I do that? Well, I guess I'm not usually jumping a lot and attacking. Oh.
Did you do
he launched me and I did my like, what's it called?
Your elemental discharge.
Yeah, elemental discharge. I did that midair. That was cool. I've never done that before.
Cool.
Well, thanks for launching me, I guess. Don't really appreciate it, but I guess. Woohoo!
Woo.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I got a fortitude jewel, a decoration that enhances the fortify. What does fortify do?
Every time you die, you get stronger.
Okay, so how much stronger? So you've got that skill, and you tell me about how much stronger you are each time you come back, but how much stronger are we talking
about? About 15% stronger, attack and defense, every time.
That sounds like a good amount. And what's this one? I stay in the air longer? A decoration that enhances the airborne skill.
I guess so. Or it increases, like, your mounting attacks, or you do more damage in the air.
Interesting.
We can check that later.
Cool. I'm a support all-star! Yeah! Hey now, I'm an all-star! Gonna get my support on! Go play! Yeah. Yeah, so the rooms are interesting because those people that we just played with are not gonna end up in our room. They're gonna go back to their own room, but they joined us for this quest. So, like, the rooms are a bit confusing at first. Ah, crap, I forgot to go back. I'm stuck out in the field right now. Wow, yeah, so we actually ended that a lot faster than I thought we would. What do we do for the next couple minutes?
We can just show off our costumes or builds or whatever costumes you want to make.
We can just chat for a bit. I don't know if we're doing more episodes. Please let us know if you're interested. We like Monster Hunter. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, Monster Hunter. It's the way to go.
Yeah.
Here, you can check out my build. These are the items I got. Whoa.
That makes a whole lot of sense to people who don't know this game.
Check out these skills.
Wow, people know exactly what's going on.
Let's just say that does a lot of damage.
Yeah, you got... Wait, I thought you said you maxed out your attack boost. What happened?
It was at 7, but I switched out my arm pieces so I can get more weakness exploit.
Ooh.
Which that does...
Extra damage to places they're weak at, yeah?
Yeah, 50% more damage.
Wow, like 50% sounds like a lot more.
It sure does.
That sounds like a whole bunch.
Here, we can check out that fortify skill.
Okay.
Oh, so your attack goes up by 10%, and your defense goes up by 15 every time you die.
Oh, okay.
Can only stack twice, though. So if you're ever in solo mode, you can die twice and be really strong.
Hell yeah. Okay. Hold on. Let's just run around and do some stuff. Just chat. Okay. I feel like I had some things on my mind. Well, I didn't talk too much. No, I explained a couple things about what I like about this game, but Highly recommend. Please play. Please play Monster Hunter. We need more people playing Monster Hunter. Mm-hmm. Why everybody not playing Monster? Why are friends not playing Monster Hunter? What y'all doing? What y'all doing? This play. Okay, this is like a super awesome multiplayer game. So that's why I really like it. I don't like playing alone. There's a big downside in the beginning. Well, really for a good chunk of it, to be honest. So for story mode, let's just talk about this, because this is my biggest gripe. Let's just spend the remainder talking about this. So, for story mode, you can play it with your friends, but only after you watch the cutscene, right?
Right, yeah.
So what has to happen if you want to progress at the same time is that both people have to go in their quest, watch their cutscenes. One person has to leave their quest while the other person, they don't have to fire a flare. The other person just chills in their quest, and then the second person who left their quest has to join the other person's quest, and then you can play the quest together. And you have to do that every single time. So what Berkeley tried to do was, Berkeley went ahead and like watched the cutscenes first. I guess he would finish the quest too, he didn't have to, but he would watch the cutscenes first, so that once I finished mine, he could just jump right in. So that's what he ended up doing, but I don't think many people, I would not have the patience to do that, to have to go ahead and then wait. So if you have a chill guy like Berkeley, that'd make it a bit easier to play, but that's my biggest gripe about it.
It's a bit of a hassle
to do. So we're kind of past that stage at this point, because we finished the story mode, but yeah, that does make a good chunk of it. How many hours do you say the story campaign took? We took a while because we did other stuff too.
We did a lot of side things, but I think it took us about 40 to 50 hours.
Yeah, so 40 to 50 hours of that pattern. That gonna be fun. But okay, that makes it sound like a really huge bad negative. It is a hassle, but you can still find a lot of fun out of it, I would say. There's still, and after the story, there's still so much to do. We're just in this like boundless endgame, and I don't know what to do. Check out that room, by the way.
Look at this rabbit thing.
Explain this mechanic. This is new to me. Berkeley explained this to me.
You can catch things on your hunts, and then you can keep them as pets.
Yeah, just like little small guys. Yeah. This was not a mechanic in previous games, so it really shocked me. So, that flash fly.
Look at this guy.
Ooh, it's such a cute pet. Look at it, this blinding ball of light. It's so great.
Wow.
Yeah, and then, I wonder if, if you catch fish, they don't become pets, they become things you can use. It'd be cool if, like, you could catch a specific fish and you could throw it in your pond. But yeah, as your story goes on, you upgrade from better room to better room. This is like the most luxurious room. This is your room. It's pretty awesome. Oh, are you checking out the things you captured?
Yeah.
Wait, what? Why would it go in that random spot in the out right there at a weird angle? Why would it go right there?
I guess that's where it goes.
What the frick?
You can see stuff goes on your carpet.
Can anything
in the pond?
This is a very important question.
Hey, look.
You can put the sushi fish. Where is it? Where'd it go? I don't see it. I guess
it's in there. Here, let me put this beetle in the garden somewhere too.
Freaking awesome, dude.
Ooh, check out my place.
Okay, this is a really important question. Oh god, this is horrible. There's just these gigantic, terrifying bugs flying around your room. What is that?
It's a vulture thing. Okay.
Oh, what the heck? This is a very important question. Uh-huh. Can anything go on your bed?
I don't think so.
Oh man, because in the previous game you would save by sleeping on your bed, but I think now you don't have to do that. So your bed, you can't even lay on it. You can't even lay on your giant luxurious plush bed. All you can do is sit on it. Please demonstrate.
Okay. Oh, there's a fish.
Oh hi. Yeah. Oh that. Okay, that's cool then. Yeah. I like that. I like that because I caught a couple fish, so I'm glad we can use that.
Here, let's take
you can't
a nap.
Even lay on your bed anymore. You just sit. And that's it! You can't use your giant, awesome bed like this. What kind of BS is... What happened? What happened?
I just threw something on the floor, and I'm feeding them.
Wait, what? There's an actual reason? There's an actual function to sitting on the bed?
How'd I do that?
Did you press something?
Yeah, I pressed a button, and then, like, it just threw some food on the floor.
What the hell, dude? Guys, we're just discovering so much right now. Sorry we're just kind of screwing around, but you're discovering with us right now.
What am I doing with my hand?
What are you doing? Are you calling something over to you? The
Come
rabbit?
Over here.
What? Did you just call that fly over to you?
Fly.
Did you just call that fly over to
here.
You?
Yeah, take that. That's right. Get out.
I can't breathe. I can't believe you just slapped that fly. You called it over to you, and it complied, and you slapped Okay, I'm okay. Right. Oh my god, I can't breathe. Oh my god. Well, thank you for joining us for this magical adventure, this magical thing of joining. I'm lightheaded, Berkeley. Mm-hmm. I'm lightheaded. Oh my god. Wait, what are you doing? What's happening? What are you doing?
I'm just showing up.
Okay, I thought something was doing that automatically. But that might be it for now. We might do an episode, another episode. I don't know, but thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time. This is Axis.
This is Berkeley.
Over and
out.
Out. Bye.